From this test of watching how these thirsty men drank from the water, the group that was chosen by God to go with Gideon to the battle were the ones who put up their hand to their mouth to drink. These men remained alert. Now God showed me something about that. Thirsty men. And I believe in Matthew 5, 6, it's talking about blessed are those who thirst after righteousness. Am I right, sisters?
Yeah.
Blessed are those. So if you got men who are hungry and thirsty for God, boy, you got some killers on your hands. I'm talking about, Bishop, we got you. Sister, we got you. You stay at the church house, we finna go out here and battle. Y'all get the meal prepared for us. We finna go fight.
All right, man.
Amen.
You men better get ready.
Amen.
Y'all in the chosen.
All right.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Glory
to God. So out of 32,000 men, God chose 300 men to go forward and have victory over their enemies. A few good, faithful, relentless, fearless men of faith. Out of 32,000, God narrowed it down to 300. Wow. God could do anything with a lot. I said, God, what you showing me there? He said, think about the 5 loaves of bread and the 2 fish. God can do a lot with a little. If everybody in here is praying, say, one, to cast out 1 down, 2, 10 down, and it multiplies. Look how many people we got in here. The devil is mad right now.
Amen.
My keys in my car. But you know what I told myself, son? We finna go in and have church. I worry about that after church because he was trying to distract me from the word going forward. Because the devil knows sometimes I'm easily frustrated about small amounts. But I say I'm finna be about my father's business right now. And God will take care of that. Ah, moving on. Point four. Great things come in small portions. A little in our eyes is a lot in the hands of the great I Am. Isaiah 55:8-9 says his thoughts and his ways are higher than ours. We must trust the instructions and directions of God. Proverbs 3:5-6. It says, lean not on your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. See, Bishop was praying about that thing. And I'm going to tell you how you knew it was from God that told you that, Bishop. Brother Freddie got in the van this morning with me. And he said, Ken, man, I spoke that van to the city. I said, what you talking about? He said, his mother-in-law was asking why Shaq, my nephew, his son, wasn't going to church with Freddie. And he said, jokingly, he said, every time he see that church man pull up, he take out running. In the spirit, he saw a church band, and we ain't had no church band yet.
Yeah.
See what I'm saying? So that was confirmation in you that you heard instructions from God to do it. Follow the instructions of God. Amen. God will always give you confirmation if you become unsure of his voice of instructions.
That's true.
There are many voices that we hear daily. And then we quit, I helped get it. Did God tell me that? Even about my fiance. Is this the one? Because so many have came in my life since I've been out. Is this the one? Is this the one?
Yeah.
And every time God. Mama, yes. Such and such. Mama, I think this is going to be a God it out. And Mama said, all right, son. Yeah, God bless you. 3 weeks later, where is she at? I wasn't warm. But God held me and he kept me for this one. He who finds the right finds the good thing and obtains favor from the Lord. See, man, we got to understand that. It might just sound like a scripture, but it's powerful.
Amen.
Women have no business looking for the man. Amen. God said, he who finds a wife finds a good thing.
Amen.
And I'm going to tell you something about the favor of God.
Amen.
Just Friday, I was tested at work. Now, so I told my friend, something going on in work that I don't know, why I thank God I don't know about it. But it was a customer that came to purchase an action. The action cost $292. I was the only one on the phone, only one running the computers. So when he came up to me, it was a Spanish guy. He said, I want two, I want two. I said, okay. I said, I looked at the receipt. I said, did you pay for it? I see one on there. He said, I want two. He said, I'm going to take $200 bills, I'm going to put it in the bathroom. You go get the $200. I know you need it. Your $200 bill, and you put it in the bathroom, mm-hmm. and you just put another X on my shirt.
Come on. Come on now.
I said, no. I told him, hey, man, this man must don't know who I am and who you I am. Even after I said no, the man said two or three more times. He said, okay, well, I'm going to put it right by the dock. $200 bill, brand new $100 bill right there on the dock. You just throw the X over there and I'm going to drive off. I said, nothing. I said, no. So I jumped on the phone, I got his orders. I said, God, what is you trying to do with me? I got on the floor, if I went back there with the axle with my co-worker, the guy got me, he got me ministered to all my co-workers at work, mm-hmm. and some of them coming to my wedding, praise God. And so when I went back there, I went to Brother T, Spanish guy, I said, T, I said, it's a Spanish guy, I'm trying to offer me $200 for an axle. He said, he described it, said, evidence has been going on. Mm-hmm. He said, he looked like this, I said, yeah. He said, nah, he's serious. He said, there ain't no test from the boss. He said, he's serious. He finna give you that money. So now, T watching me. This is the man I've been telling about Jesus. You better be careful when you speak the word. You better let how you live before folks.
Yeah. Man. Yeah.
So when T saw me grab one axle off the rack, he started smiling. And I took the axle up there, and T took his parcel down. And then I'm going to tell you what this man did. The same man tried to proposition me. I told my fiance, he had some money in his hand. He balled the money up. And he put that money in my hand like this here. He said, glasses, amigo. And got out and left out the door.
Amen.
I know a little Spanish. He was telling me thank you. At all. So now, I told Bishop, I took the money and I put the money in my pocket. Because now I'm still trying to find God. What is you doing? I didn't give him nothing. But he still gave me some money. God said, first of all, the man honored your integrity. God needs soldiers with integrity.
Yeah.
Not to just talk it, but to walk it.
That's right.
When you have integrity, the people will listen. The people will follow. If you have integrity. A woman clings to a man with integrity.
Amen. That's right.
If she leaves her house and leaves $5,000 in her purse, she know one thing. It's going to be there when she gets back.
Amen.
Because of a man of integrity. So, when I got that money, my other co-worker came back. I guess just the one that he had been doing business with. I didn't say nothing. God told me, shut up. He went to Jack in the Box. He bought me a hamburger, some fries, and a soda. I said, thank you. I said, man, how much do I owe you? First, he hesitated. He said, man, you owe me $5. I gave him the same $5, and I told Bishop, I said, man, God bought me lunch. Five, the number of grace. The moment I did what God would have me to do, I told her, I said, the Spirit of God spoke to me and said, you have a special grace because of this one little small test you passed. She went to work yesterday. And sometimes it's slow in her beauty shop. And she went and had a marvelous day yesterday. And I told her, because what the head does trickles on down. See what I'm saying? See, if I would have took that money, it probably caused these two men right here from getting their scholarship. Amen. It probably caused this young lady and this young man from excelling in school. And it probably wreaked havoc on her beauty shop.
Thank you, Jesus.
Because of the choice I made.
Yes.
We're not going to be married physically to next week, but we're married in the spirit.
Amen.
So what I do,
amen.
I'm held accountable.
Amen.
And not only that, if you want to go deeper with it, it probably would affect the shepherd's house.
Amen.
It probably would affect you. It probably been now sold in here today. Amen. If I would have did like Achan.
Come on, Troop.
And we hid that money. Because you know what? She looked at him, she said, God had blessed me so much. All this stuff, we were trying to figure out how we was going to pay for this wedding. It totaled up $35,000. And God done did. Everything we prayed for this week. Yeah, you look at me. But you were able to go to bro. We were able to go do some things yesterday. Pay my car and everything. And then, you know, the one of the guys blessed me. And I said, wow, just because I done that. So she looked at me. She said, honey? I said, why you look at me like that? She said, you sure got a lot of money.
Amen.
Wait, I was just so excited. Let me get on. One seat. There is power in praising God.
Amen.
Praise is a weapon of mass destruction. Praise to God disrupts the plans of the enemy and brings down strongholds. Remember the wall of Jericho after the 7-day march? The walls came tumbling down. When they lifted up their horns and voiced on one accord, nothing can stand up against praise and worship unto a sovereign God. Now I'm going to tell you something. I understood when Jesus came, the bishop said it this morning. He said, I don't know why y'all looking, I'm doing this for me. He know praise and worship connects you to the anointing. When the women began to pray, they're not worried about how pretty they are or what they got on. Bishop said, y'all get up here. They got up in the store. Praise God. It breaks strongholds. It brings deliverance. That's the women. Now check this out. When I was down there in prison, I led a choir. I didn't even know I had the gift. I write music. I did a little gospel rap. But what got me through that time in prison, I praised God every day. When I went to the commissary line and put my card in there and it wasn't on there, you know what I did? I walked away from there praising God. Thank you, Jesus. I got 3 videos. And God would always send somebody. He touched folks in my life that I didn't even know was sending me money. One was going to come today. His name is Justin Mummy. He told me, tell y'all to pray for his son. His son is sick. He wanted to be here away from Rockwall, Texas. When you praise and worship God, it strengthens us as a body. But it has to be done in unity, on one accord. When he's getting his praise on, guess what? I'm going to chime in with him. It's going to catch a fire. Boom, 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 boom. Then the Holy Spirit moves. Because you know why? The devil once was the praise leader in heaven until he fell from grace. So when you hear people praising God, he's mad. He's mad. He'll have a young man that was praising God at 1 minute on this side go right out there and turn on rap. Out there. Because he don't want you to be focused on the things of God. Oh, I'm trying to get out of here. Praise and worship will cause your enemies to flee. The enemy of anger, as Saul. The enemy of lust, as David. The enemy of bondage, as Paul and Saul. The enemy of shame and guilt, just as the woman who was called the adultery. Now, all these men brought this lady before Jesus and said, Lord, she was called the adultery. When I first read that scripture as a baby Christian, I said, hold up. There's something wrong with that. They got her like, where's the man at?
Yeah.
They wanted to kill her.
Yeah.
She probably even set up, sister. Well, she came. She didn't make no excuses. She didn't try to, she didn't do none of that. She fell before Jesus. Jesus kneeled down. We never know what he wrote in the sand. He wrote something. And he said, let he who without sin cast the first stone. There's a lot of stones been cast at y'all over y'all life. Jesus said, he who without sin didn't cast the first stone. See, that stagnates a soldier when stones are being chunked at you. That's what I'm trying to say. When you have always your life stones been cast at you, it causes you not to want to fight. You just like your daddy, that's a stone. Oh, deadbeat baby daddy, that's a stone. That's why I had the women to declare over these men life of who they are. Men of God, we have to teach them how to dress as men of God.
Amen.
How to go about
seeing
the vision. How to pray. Because if they don't know how to do it, they'll be stuck in situations. I was stuck in a situation. And God turned it around for me. Oh, I got 2 more points. I'm about to do. Point 7. You must remain unified a house divided against itself will not stand. Do not allow division to rise up. There is power and spiritual anointing and unity of the body of Christ. Oh, they said that Jesus was casting devils out in the name of Beelzebub. They didn't know who Jesus was. Jesus told them a house divided will not stand. So how would I be, if I'm on the devil's side, how would I be casting demons out and I'm on the devil's side?
All right.
See what I'm saying?
Yes.
With this army, you got to be unified. If you have heard a rumor or gossip about your fellow soldier, you know what you're supposed to do? Say, pray for him.
Amen.
Rebuke that in the name of Jesus, because that's the devil.
Yeah.
Bring division.
Yeah.
So what? That's what God said. Look it up in the word. God said, so what?
Amen.
My son died for him. You didn't die for him.
Yeah.
The blood covers them.
Yeah.
Now it's their part to come before me. Now he said, come boldly before the throne of grace, that you may obtain grace at the time of need. Okay, now check this out. If a soldier is unified with another, come here, Baltimore, stand by him. Come here, y'all two come over here. Y'all two come over here. Lock your arm with him. Come right here, bitch. Come right here. Come right here. They got to see.